Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening to wherever you are in the world today. Hello, my name is Queen Aminata, and I am bringing a very special initiative here to you today. This is what it's about. Fighting period poverty. Before I get into all of what we're doing and why we're doing it and how we're going to do it, I want to give a special shout out to my sister, Her Royal Highness Nana Asamoah in Ghana. This all sparked because of her. Kudos to you, Nana, for serving your people. We were having a conversation as sisters. We were just talking, and she brought up this issue and how it's a serious problem in her community. The girls aren't able to go to school because they don't have access to the needed things that they need when they're on their cycle. So I said to her, this is an opportunity, and maybe we can work together and partner with some people to help raise the funds to buy the things that the girls need. She loved it, and so that's what brought us here today. So that's what I want to talk to you about today. I've partnered with several organizations who are going to work with me and Nana to help get these funds. So first organization that we're working with is Could You. Now this is where we're going to get the menstrual cups, because we're doing the cups. And this organization is so wonderful. They're based in the United States. They provide cups, they provide education and training, and they provide jobs to the local community. So Could You Cup is a very powerful organization dedicated to fighting period poverty. So that's our first partner. They're a major partner because they're the ones where we're going to get the cups from. Voice of Zongo Communities in Ghana, you guys, this organization is, I'm telling you, they're doing some wonderful things. They're dedicated to bringing needed services to underprivileged communities throughout Ghana. So we've partnered with them. That's our local NGO in Ghana that we're working with. We're also partnered with GHMA. Now this organization is dedicated to mental health issues. They're based in India, and they are important for this mission because period poverty affects the psyche. It affects the psyche. So we need to educate our girls on, you know, what can they do to deal with the psyche? That's where GMAJ comes in. This next organization, you guys, it's called IDO. This organization is global. They're all over the world. And their mission is to build a network with a common goal of promoting and using culture for unity and social inclusion. You guys, that's powerful. They're all about unity, teaching people about culture, sharing different cultures, why they matter, how we can work together to make this world a better place in unity as one people. That's IDO. And last but not least, I'm a HERS girl. And HERS is spelled H-E-R-R-S. That stands for healing, empowering, restoring, reorganizing, and supporting. You guys, this company right here deals with the inner self, the broken part that people don't see. We all wear a mask when we're in public, right? People don't know what we're going through at home, how we're suffering physically or mentally, and what we're going through. This organization deals with that. It's a powerful, powerful thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put links to all these different organizations either down below or up above, depending on what platform you're watching this video on. And I would encourage everyone watching this video to click on those links and get familiar with these different organizations and find out which one touches you and get involved and help support them. So now let's talk about the actual initiative that we're doing. What we want to do is raise enough money to purchase 1,000 menstrual cups to pass out in 4 different regions in Ghana: the Ashanti region, the Eastern region, the Volta region, and the Northern region. So that's our goal, and we wanna do this by October. Now each cup costs just a small amount of $10, and it lasts for 10 years. You guys, that is amazing. $10 gets you 10 years worth of services. Not only does the cup last for 10 years, but your $10 donation also is going to provide a job for a local woman in the community that we're serving, because the Could You Cup provides a job. They hire local women to make the sacks that the girls will keep the cups in. So you're going to be providing employment to an unemployed person in the local community, which is going to stimulate the economy in the local community and enable that person to be able to feed their family. That's awesome. You're also, with your $10 donation, going to be contributing to the life of a young girl who wouldn't otherwise be able to attend school, because now she's going to have what she needs when she's on her cycle to be able to go to school. Also, you're going to be providing education. Why is that? Because Could You Cup also goes into these local communities where we're doing these services, and they provide education not only to the girls on how to use the cup, the importance of cleanliness, and how to stay clean and take care of your body, but they also educate the boys to remove, to help remove the stigma of the monthly cycle. You guys, I'm telling you, this is a powerful, powerful thing. And the other thing that your $10 is going to go to, guess what? Helping the economy. So all of my environmentalists out there, this is for you. And you might say, how is that, Queen Aminata? Well, guess what? I'm glad you asked. Let me tell you. This helps the economy because these cups, like I said, last for 10 years. That means every month there's not all these sanitary napkins going into the dump, messing up the environment. We don't have all these tampons being flushed down the toilet, messing up the water system and the plumbing system and all this kind of stuff. We don't have any of that because the cup lasts for 10 years. So for a mere $10, you get to provide employment, provide education, change the life of a young girl, and save the environment. Wow. Talk about bang for your buck. It doesn't get any better than that, my friends. It doesn't get any better than that. So I want to put out an all call and challenge everybody listening to this video to just do two simple things. What are those two things? Number one, donate. I'm going to have the links down below. You go straight to Could You Cup and make your $10 donation. If you can do more than $10, of course, we would love that. We're not going to turn it down, but we're asking everybody to do a minimum $10. And of course, that $10, if you're in the United States, is tax deductible. So that'll encourage you to do more for everybody that needs some deductions come tax time, right? The more you give, the more you save on your taxes. And the second thing I want to encourage everybody to do is to not only share this out across your social media platforms, but to talk about this outside of your social media. That means when you're at the gym, when you're in your church groups and faith groups, when you're at happy hour with your friends, when you're at the backyard barbecue, whatever it is that you do, bring up this topic and share what all of these different groups have come together to do to help change the life of a young girl. You guys, I'm psyched and excited. And for all of those people out there that know me on a personal level, they know that even though I don't have the gift of song, I always have a song in my heart. And having said that, I want us to go out on a high note. I want to play a song for you guys today by the late, great Teddy Pendergrass. Now, I don't own the rights to the song, but the song is what I woke up with on my heart today as I was thinking about this video and what I was going to say. And so I said, you know what? I'm going to play the video, and this is what I want you guys to do. I want you to listen to the song. The beat is great, and we're going to be bopping to the beat perfect. I want to pump your spirits up. But more importantly, what I want you to do is listen to the words that Teddy is saying. I want you to let those words sink down into your heart and get into your spirit. And I want you to let it fester there as you ponder on it. Let it stir in your spirit. And then let that stirring spark. And let that spark ignite you to move. Move to action. Move to change the life of a young girl. Move to help the environment. Move to supply employment to somebody. Move to provide education to somebody. You guys, this is what it's all about. We always talk about each one, reach one. This is your chance to do just that. Each one, reach one. Donate that $10. So I'm gonna play the song right now. Remember, I don't own the rights to this song, but this song is so applicable for what we're trying to do. Are you ready? Get ready to listen. Are you ready? Get ready. Ready? Na 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 na. Change it, 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 change it I can't do it alone. I need some help, y'all. I can't do it alone. Hey. Wake up, everybody. Need a little help, y'all. Change the world. Hey. Help that is, help that.